guys doing today? I bet I'm shocking you with my blue. Oh yeah, I went by Ulta yesterday and I got a little crazy, I got a little goof on. That's not art related though, and today is art related. We're going to be painting Cheerful Chickadee on our live event. Live events are a little different than our uploads, in which, you know, people ask questions and we answer them, and sometimes we change it up from the basic design, which we are doing today. I hope you all are excited about that and ready to, like, take that chickadee to that next level, or as some of our community likes to say, Sherpify our chickadee. We might Sherpify it. I don't know. You can see I'm kind of in a weird mood today with the blue. I'm so blue. Anyways, I am. I'm feeling blue.
Why is that?
I don't know. I didn't really have anything humorous past. I'm feeling blue and blue lipstick. I kind of felt like that was enough. I felt like everyone under 25 wearing blue lipstick everywhere just felt a disturbance in the force.
They did. So hi.
Hi.
How you guys doing?
This may become honeys.
I'm John. I'm Cinnamon's husband.
Oh, yeah. Usually introduce John. If you've never been here before, that voice is John. John tracks me with one of our four cameras, and he also reads the chat and tries to help answer questions and tries to make sure that you guys know what's going on. Mm. The simple version of this will be going up today and will be in the iCard, which is just a direct teaching of this guy on this branch. Real easy pie.
Yeah.
But you guys don't get that today.
No.
No. We're going to really just kind of drill down deep. Because I feel like the lives ought to have something more. Something juicier. I was going to do something and then I realized John wasn't there to switch cameras. I was going to talk about the paint palette. No, you're good.
I'm good.
No, you're
good. I can talk about the paint palette.
I just did not know where you were. It's totally okay.
At least everywhere.
I didn't scream.
It's true.
That's as easily could happen. And for you guys at home with this thing hooked up to my face, that could have been a real moment in your lives.
So where did you get? So there's so many questions going on. Let's go ahead. I'm going to save some of these questions. Let's go ahead and jump in there. You talk about the palette, and then we'll get to the. Okay.
Okay. I'm sure I know what the questions are.
Okay.
What was that? What's that? Uh-oh. There's a noise. We have to investigate it. It's one of those noises we have to investigate. Yeah, I'm trying some new stuff out today. I don't know if I like it. John's checking on. It's probably just a video game that's gone really, really well, and that's a victory cheer. But you gotta look at all the loud noises. All right, we'll try again.
She was yawning.
Oh, okay. Sure. Burnt sienna. Cad red medium. Cad yellow medium. Save money, and you know, if you buy hue, if you're at all concerned, have you know, any safety or health concerns at all about this, you just buy hue and it saves you a lot of money. Though really the stuff coming back is saying it's not as exciting as everyone seems to think it was at one point. Yellow ochre, Mars black, titanium white, and this is a switch up, ultramarine blue. Yeah. But because I think it's a very good fall blue. It's got that slight purple tint to it. And it's a very nice fall blue. And we have it in our paint list. And we haven't used it in a while. So now we are.
You're cracking people up with your lipstick.
I know, man. I don't know why I do stuff.
I think it's awesome. I didn't know this.
Give them reasons to make comments.
So, you know, I didn't know that she was wearing blue lipstick before she walked out there. And I had to go, I'm color balancing what?
You know, you gotta. The thing is it's very hard to drink my coffee.
All right.
If you want to know how to draw this on Facebook in the video section, we actually drew the chickadee on a branch last night. So if you're just like, I really want to be able to draw this freehand in, we got that. But I also have a traceable description below. Traceable, finished image, all of that description below. So that you don't have to draw to do this. I'm going to get my brush a little wet.
Okay.
Oh, wait. I'm going to show y'all something.
What are you going to show us?
Because you're here for the lives. So you guys ask me about this all the time. This is acrylic flow release. A couple companies have it.
Yeah.
As per the manufacturer's instructions, I'm mixing a small amount into my water. You never want to spray this stuff.
Okay, yeah.
I don't actually know why. it just says don't do it for any reason. So generally the paint companies have a good process behind why that is.
Mm-hmm.
And because they don't want airbrush artists and other artists that aerosolize their paint to be at risk. So that's a lot of the safety labels.
Yeah, I think that
right
up there with not eating paint is breathing it.
Yeah, don't breathe your paint. Airbrush artists should be very, very careful.
Yeah, but they know wear that. Masks. You know.
Yeah, they all talk to each other and they know that. I have on my canvas today healing from Mason. Mason really needs you guys to send him. He's a little brush and he needs some healing energy right now and some love. And so does little brush Olivia. They're both going through some big medical stuff right now, and just angels and healing and healers surrounding them. And Kim Sim's uncle had a fall and could really use a speedy recovery. I may add another wish here, but I'm going to show you what I do to my canvases. So we've all had the pitting.
Now, while you're putting that up there, I'm gonna say we had a lot of wishes that came in yesterday that we weren't able to capture. We had over 1,000 comments come in there in our Facebook chat last night.
And we're still getting through them.
We're still going through them all. So anyone who got any of those wishes, I know we had a lot of little brush wishes in there. You know, I thank you to all the lightkeepers to capture those and get them out there. Oh, and for Uncle Jack, and you know, for all of the pregnancies and the stuff, we're definitely capturing those wishes and putting them out there.
Yeah, we're definitely. So you see, I'm just brushing this on. Now, what is acrylic flow release? This is a water conditioning agent, and it breaks down the surface tension of water.
Mm-hmm.
Actually, this was developed for raw linen canvas and other staining procedures where you don't want any surface tension. And it can also help if you have really crummy water, which, you know, sometimes we have hard, hard water. I'm just brushing that on.
Now, what exactly is pitting?
Pitting is the word I'm now using to describe the fact that you're painting happily, minding your own biz, and there's these little white spots all over your canvas.
Yeah?
Yeah. And what I believe it is, and I'm still waiting to get confirmation, I'm going to keep running it down. You know, I'm a member of NAMTA, so I'm going to keep asking for art material information.
Help us!
I think that there must be a coating that they're applying to these for shipping, something to prevent mold or some other, you know, common shipping issue with canvases that also resist paint, which makes canvases a bit problematic. So this has been my solution for it. Do I have any wishes I want to add before?
So a wish for smooth pregnancies. And there was some wishes for those who were over 65 to not have any pregnancies.
Yeah, I think your wish is granted. Or you're famous.
There's just this stark contrast of like, yay, no more pregnancies.
I know. It's really... My last one was my last one.
and we're looking forward
to grandchildren and when they finally grow up and give me one.
And hugs to all the new moms who want to have pregnancies.
And hugs to the new moms. And hugs to all the chickadees who went back to school. My daughter, I want to wish that all the kids who are starting their new school year are safe and happy. My daughter had a rough day yesterday. And
some husbands need some wishes out there.
Yeah.
I see a couple of husband wishes.
What are our husband wishes?
Let's see, some illness. I see it's scrolling up really fast. Oh. Wish for Steven, who I think is fighting an infectious disease.
Oh, healing. We wish that for you, Steven. Healing.
And
then what's great is I can keep doing this, and then they go into the canvas.
They just get worked in there. And thank you to all of our light users. By the way, we have over 250 people with us today right now hanging out here painting. So thank you, guys. Cinnamon can't see the chat, so I give her little updates here.
Yeah.
They really like your bracelet and your necklace. Just wanted to pass that along. They think you look fabulous today.
It's like a camouflage to, like, explain the blue lips.
You're on your blue period.
Oh, sweetie. Really?
It's just like all
I felt the collective groan from the community. Did you guys
come on.
Thank you for hanging out today. I'm going to be starting with Goldilocks here for those of you in the know. I just don't know how to follow that up. I'm going to be starting here with Goldilocks for those of you in the know. Goldilocks is a number 10 bright with a firm filament. And so brights are square. They're slightly shorter than flats. That would be the difference if you never heard of that. We have lessons that go faster than this. If you're like, oh my gosh, what's going on? You know, you'll just got to wait a little bit and it will be up. I'm going to take a smidge of my yellow, just tipped on my brush. I don't want too much, over to my white here. And I'm going to get my glazing medium. This is my acrylic glazing medium gloss.
You put the flow release that you had on there, you put that on there before your gesso or after your gesso?
I don't apply gesso. These canvases are all pre-gessoed.
Okay. So you just added that there.
I just added it to improve the surface tension of my canvas so that I wouldn't experience pitting, which I have not been enjoying. You guys have not been enjoying. By the way, people have been saying that they've been very successful. I just wiped off my brush. I'm getting a little more white paint. They've been very successful with just water. I have not been as successful with just water. So I have just, and I have the flow, and I have it here. I think you could probably just rinse your canvas and allow it to dry as well. Because again, I feel like this is a coating. So I'm going to talk about this little blending situation that we've got going here. I'm making this little area of light that's going to imply my sun. And it's quite light around this edge. This isn't quite the bokeh that we've been talking about. We may even mess around and do some of that. I don't know today. But what it does do is give us that nice blended feel. So where I've got that nice edge here, I'm going to come get a bunch of the white out. And I'm going to get a smidge just on the corner of my ultramarine blue. I'm going to pull a little blending medium here. And I'm going to blend a very nice edge with a soft pressure between these two fields.
Yeah, let me ask you a quick question here, because this were pertaining back to the
ask me any questions. This is the live. I get to chat. I'm allowed to talk.
So if you are going to add gesso, do you use that stuff? Do you use that stuff that you just had there before or after that?
If you were going to gesso,
yes,
you would use it after. Gotcha. It's an additive to your water only, and what it does is it conditions your water.
Okay.
You don't add it to your gesso. You don't add it to your paint. It's not something you put in those products. And there's a really good video. I don't know off the top of my head. I assume they have one. Liquitex probably has one. But I know Golden has a great video on their YouTube channel about the use of flow release.
So, there were some questions on our flow relief the same as flow improver?
Yeah. They're very similar products.
Okay. And to read the labeling.
Always read the labeling, because think of it, the Liquitex glazing liquid is not at all like the Golden glazing liquid. They're very different products. And so sometimes that does happen in paint.
Mm-hmm.
But, you know, the paint companies really want you to know what you're using and what it's for. So generally the good ones will have ample instructions on their websites.
Gotcha.
And it does help. Some of them better than others. And you'll find that they all have kind of a style, kind of a corporate culture and a style. And you may find one company just explains what they've got in a way that you relate to better than another company. And that's cool. So, just because something doesn't work in one company's, experience for you, don't think that it just doesn't work at all. It just might be that product, that company. And you might do really well with another product, another company.
Right.
That's why artists are so weird in particular.
So this one, one of the things that
I'm getting some ultramarine and some white, and I'm darkening my color as I'm going out.
Now, I'm going to ask, one of the things I'm going to have you do is I'm going to look over your left shoulder here. One of the things about the whites that she's got on this is that they're so bright that they're at the limit of the camera's ability to differentiate between them and the white canvas there. So
yeah.
Except there on that close up where you can see there, you had Simmons' hat like to play with it. But you
can
see
really
there.
That's really washed out.
Well, it's much clearer on the screen over here, but
okay.
It is real close there. So
okay.
I'll see if we can.
Cameras are not like people's.
No, they don't.
So just to that end, your goal for this as you're going is to be every time you make a new fade out, you're trying to fade between the space in front of you, right? You can even go back with your brush, especially if you've got the glazing medium or Grumbacher retarder. You can keep softening this edge, and you can get a very close to oil effect.
Yeah.
Which is nice. And so I'm just taking a little more time. Usually I whip through this technique real fast. But today, I have decided on my lives I'm allowed to chat. I'm allowed to tell stories. I'm going to show you guys some cool new tricks. For everyone that shows up at a live, if you want a drill down lesson, that gets uploaded and they're short and they're very direct. And there's not a lot of, there's still some, like, you know, love yourself and be good to each other. I can't not do that. I'm a care about the world shark. If I'm not doing it, I'm not going.
Mm-hmm.
I wonder if we should do something for Shark Week. So I got a little pitting right there. So I'm having, this is where my firm brush really helps me with the pitting, is where I start to see it. Then I can work those bristles
into
the
zoom,
canvas.
I'm going to zoom in on some of that there.
Oh. Okay, well, I'll develop some of it down here.
Okay, yeah.
And then you can kind of see where it's pitted.
I'll zoom down on that.
Yeah, and then we'll just talk about that.
Oh, there you go.
We'll be like, good mythical morning. We'll talk about that. Oh, yeah. Keep blending my edges while you're finding it.
I'm on there right now.
Okay. So you can see this kind of white spotting and pitting.
Yep.
I'm going to grab my little paint and my white. And I'm going to work the paint into the canvas. So
I'm going to have to ask you just to lean
this is way. Much worse when I don't pre-treat the canvas. And I know some of you guys have had some real experiences and felt some real frustration.
Can I stunt hands you for just a moment?
You can do anything you need,
hold
babe.
Hold on just a second. I'm thinking we can do a great deal to improve this. Hold on a second.
Okay. Am I going to be physically moved? I step back. Oh, is the easel in the wrong place? Yes, I love what you do to not be on camera. It cracks me up. I wish you could see what he's doing to not be on camera. Though on our Guys on Camera collab, I want you to know that we're getting yeses from the guys, so it looks like it's a go. Looks like it's a go.
So
I'm sure makes John very, very nervous.
That way I can get just a little bit better angle there for the other camera.
So I'm pulling the ultramarine out, and I'm just tinting it or toning it with the white. I had a really good question the other day.
Oh, yeah?
About using golden opens as a retarder.
Oh, really?
Yeah. And so, so they had some golden open titanium white. Could we just get a tube of titanium white in the golden open and use that to slow the drying time of the paint down? And what I'll say is, according to the manufacturer, the golden opens can be used with the regular acrylic paints, and they do change the drying time of the regular acrylic paints. The regular acrylic speeds up the drying time of the open, and the open slows down the drying time of the regular acrylic. Now, my mom is not as fond. She's done more with it than I have. She did a whole run of tests. I haven't done those tests, but I think that's worth exploring. So I may actually explore how those products work together.
Yeah.
And see what I think of doing that as a trick, because it might be really good. And I love when you guys have ideas like that. Sometimes you think, oh, well, I'm learning, so probably nothing I'm thinking or saying or doing has that much value. Like who am I? I've heard many of you say, like, who am I to say anything? Hmm. Right? But you are somebody to say something. You're in this. You're painting. You're having experiences. You're thinking outside the box. You literally could come up with something innovative or have an insight, or still, we're always learning from each other.
Mm-hmm.
You know? So who are you? You are awesome. That's who you are. That's what I think. Speak up. Use your voice. You know? Might be something really, really cool.
So how I'm going to come over here and rope cam. I think we got a much better view now. I had it for some reason there, guys. I had the I let that.
We're going to do a second kind of treatment to the sky to make it look more finished, more resolved, and less like a paint night painting.
Unless?
Mm-hmm. Right? We're going to take this to that next level so people can start moving this into a more finished product. Isn't that nice?
Yeah.
Just some more stuff, because this is our first layer.
Boy, you're big brush strokes there.
I am?
Yeah, you are.
Okay. I felt like I was going real slow.
Well, you're just like these big, long, sweeping brush strokes here because it's. I'm noticing because I'm on RoboCam here.
Oh.
And so it's, you know, I have to kind of zoom out a bit for, because you go from what these big sweeps.
Mm-hmm.
And so can you talk about that a little bit? How are you doing that? Is that, where are you, you know, how do you do such an even big stroke like that?
I think that I have a lot of muscle memory is the honest truth here. I think that I stand at my easel a lot every day, and I have a good fluid rotation in my shoulder, so it's easy for me to take the brush on the flat and just flow it up.
Yeah, I see you got your arm way up there, so it's yeah. it's you're really, yeah. your full body's engaged in that, huh?
Yeah, I get a lot of questions. Should I be sitting? Should I be standing? Should I be at an easel? Should I be at a table? And what I'll say is whatever you're at, make sure your body positioning is good. If you're at a table, make sure you're not hunched over and hurting your back. If you're at an easel, make sure you have a gel mat under your feet. Even if you're young. Even if you're like Miss Yoga Pilates Awesomeness. Oh, by the way, if you are Miss Yoga Pilates Awesomeness, good for you. That stuff is hard.
Oh, my gosh.
But you should still put a gel mat under your feet, sweetie.
You know what?
Hmm.
I am looking over here, and there are 299 people in the room
no.
here with us.
Are we dancing?
I mean, I'm not even kidding. I just looked over and saw all these people here hanging out with us. Thank you, guys. 301. There's definitely
a Sherpa group dance coming
there's,
on.
There's a Sherpa dance coming
I feel
on.
Like
I just
John
get,
should join us in the Sherpa dance.
I just have to,
he doesn't feel
I have to
he should.
Find. There's, you know, maybe I can't find any music.
No, come on. Give me a beat.
Give you some music there?
Give me a beat.
Let me see if I can find some.
We got to celebrate being together and being positive.
Do Sherpa.
And if you're at home, give yourself a little dance. If you can't move, that's okay. Give yourself a little finger.
Yeah.
Maybe it's a little toe wiggle.
Yep.
Defy.
We are Sherpa for sure.
We are.
And thank you guys. I want to say, don't forget to like, comment, subscribe, and share. And for sure, post up all the pictures. We want to see all your chickadees.
I want to see your chickadees. I'm so glad my chickadees are, like, in school and doing. They're working so hard. I have big kind of news. I love Spider's teacher this year.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, boy. You know, she's really good. Like, right from the packet, I was like, this lady's on point. Last year, not as much. But this year, so good. I'm, like, such a fan. I'm, like, so excited. Yeah. He's so excited. He spent last year not feeling like he was a very smart guy. And this year, he's feeling sort of hopeful about that. And she's already conveyed that. I'm like, I could just go hug her. She might even get a painting. I don't like her. She doesn't know I like her. But I do.
Because you keep secrets so well.
Well, you know what I'm pretty much counting on is nobody's watching the show. So as long as no one watches the show, this stuff will never get out.
Right. We just assume that no one there watches.
So here's the trick. If I'm going to go back and work this center area, sometimes people want to rinse the brush they've been working on that has this heavy load of blue in it and then go back over their light area. But you don't really want to do that because what will happen is a micro amount of the pigment will still be in your brush and it's going to start making everything green on you.
Okay.
So I'm going to rinse this out and put this in water. I'm going to get a fresh brush, maybe a little smaller than this. I'm going to get a number 8, right?
Mm-hmm. Oh, I'm supposed to remind you to make calls to action.
Oh, guys, if you like lessons like this and you think this live crazy thing is a lot of fun and you'd like to see more of it,
okay. No,
be sure to like, comment, and subscribe. Is that the call to action?
See, now you got to do it facing the camera. See? Oh. Now you got to
Hi!
Do it. Okay,
we should subscribe.
Start over.
Because blue lipstick, maybe?
There you go. Now tell
we
them.
We teach art for free.
Yep.
And we like you, and we care that you can paint.
Where's the iCard?
There's an iCard, and there's more. There's nothing in it currently.
Time travelers.
There will be an iCard for you on the replay.
Yep.
So if you want, if you're like, this is just taking forever and you don't love that, we've got the drilled down really quick, fast lesson. We're trying to make sure everything is accessible for everybody. Speaking of accessibility, I want to shout out my closed captioners.
Oh, yeah.
I don't know if you guys noticed this, but our closed caption playlist has just exploded with new content. So now we have even more videos that are accessible. And that is the most amazing thing. I can't even imagine because there's not enough accessible art content out there, and I so appreciate their hard work. And it's a team, and they're like amazing. I'm going to come back to my center here.
Now, yeah.
Now, anything. I'm just painting.
Oh, no, you're good.
I'm just going to do kind of this bright little sun here in the center. We're going to, and I'm just dry brushing this brighter yellow around. Can you see how I'm doing that?
Yeah, I'm going to come inside there a little. Zoom
I'm
in.
Just very lightly dashing this around. I'm just trying to create the sense of radiating light. You know how fall days are cold but sunny?
Yeah.
And I feel like the back to school days, the first ones, are like that. They're cold but they're sunny. And it's fun to do these sort of tunneled skies, but I think it's also really helpful to do the finishing work on them. So I'm going to wipe off my brush here. I might even wipe it off on my towel. I'm going to grab some white and kind of come here with this lighter color. And I'm just going to work my sky to a more finished place. One of the things that we sometimes do because we're rushing through these paintings is we're not always getting them to a completely finished, resolved place. And that can be super frustrating.
There we go.
So we're just going to create the sense of light that's happening in our sky. And this will look really lovely on our little chickadee. And you can see how it's sort of creating just a little more drama there, doesn't it?
Yeah.
Just a little more resolution. And I like that. I want a little more resolution. Rinse out my brush. Rinsing it out. And I'm going to get my white with just a tint of my ultramarine, which I love how it's slightly purple. Pulling my glazing medium. You don't need the glazing medium for these effects. I do because I'm in the studio that's very hot.
Now I'm going to close in.
And there's air conditioning in here and it dries out the room. I know many of you that are next to air conditioners are having that problem. Then I would say you need what I need. If you're next to an air conditioner painting and your paint is drying out, you need what I need. You may even need, depending on your circumstances, to switch to golden opens. Or Atelier, I can never say it, but there's a couple of you guys that paint with it because you paint with Wilson Bickford, the Atelier acrylics.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, that's another one that doesn't dry easily. There are some products out there that do that. They're a little more pricey, but, you know, they could make a really big difference in your painting experience. And sometimes that's what's important, is just having a good time while you're painting, because this is your time.
So how many hoots of a painting is this?
I you know, by the time we're done, I think it's going to be many hoots.
Many hoots?
Actually, that's going to be a funny joke later.
Oh, no.
Because of the direction we're going with the painting. I want us to do something that just really kicks off our fall fun.
You move around that 16 by 20 canvas so fast.
I do? I feel like I'm just dragging today.
Man, RoboCam is like, RoboCam. I can't keep up.
We need to turbify RoboCam.
I can, but RoboCam.
Turbify the RoboCam.
He turns into NauseaCam real quick.
NauseaCam. We need to put up a trigger warning in case you have any kind of epileptic disorder going on. I don't know if actually we do. We might. On the nausea cams, because that can be, vertigo is not fun.
Not fun. That's why I'm trying to be very careful about
triggers
like,
are not fun.
I try not to move the camera around too much when I'm on it. Sometimes it's just, you go so fast, it's hard to.
I gotta go fast.
You're a path painter.
I gotta go fast.
I think Ethel's out here.
Hi, Ethel. I know Jane is back. I'm so happy Jane is back.
Good
Her
to see you.
Computer is working. Everybody say, hey.
Hey.
Where you been, Jane? We missed you. We really like you. I'm glad you're back. This is not a singing show, don't worry. Oh, I'm going to get comments. You know what's so funny? Because like we're doing the two kinds of videos now.
Uh-huh.
So everybody can kind of get what they need out of it. Because honestly, there are five distinct learning styles. I'm sure teachers actually are really, you know, up on this information. People don't learn mm-hmm. the same. They don't digest information the same. And even with our two kinds, it may not be right for everybody, and that's cool. But, you know, I I think the lives have kind of like are sort of self-explanatory. It's always funny when somebody wanders in here and is like, what's going on? You just won't stop talking.
We're punching evil in the face.
We're punching evil in the face today. I'm sorry. Was it noisy? Am I punching evil in the face?
Well, pow.
We're going to be doing a bark quest this week.
Mm-hmm. Are there going to be puppies?
There will be no puppies on our bark quest.
Why not?
We're just going to do trees.
Oh.
We're going to not paint decorative trees. We're going to paint trees.
You're going to have to leave me out of this one.
I am? Why do I have to leave you? How do I never catch these when they happen? I don't. Anyways, so you can kind of see this is a more dramified sky. More dramified sky. This is the weird. I don't know what I think of this lipstick. I mean, it's here and we're living with it. I'm going to draw my canvas and be like, maybe I'm going back to my Texas toast and my purple.
Okay.
And he's going to get a nice sky blue.
Well, while she's doing that, I'm going to say thank you guys for coming and hanging out with us. Oh my gosh, there's so many people here. We've got over 300 people all hanging out. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. And I really would. I would like to see lots of different little chickadees because this has like been one of my favorite paintings that Cinnamon's done in a long time. It's cute, cute, cute little chickadee. So I would love to see lots of pictures up on Facebook of cute little chickadees on little branches, all being cutie, cutie, cutie. So thank you guys for coming and hanging out. Big art hugs to all the people who are coming back. Jane, haven't seen you in a while. Glad you're feeling better. All of our community who's out there on the mend, really glad to have you guys with us. And for a lot of new people, thanks for coming and joining us. And don't forget to like, comment, subscribe, and share. Do all that kind of stuff. You can find more information about where to view of us on our website. That's coming up some more. And the Sherpa is now bored and making faces, so you can talk to her now.
I'm serious. I'm a very serious artist. Serious artist.
Certainly.
I am a juried serious artist.
There was a time.
There was once this time. I'm going to move my branch down for this a little bit because I'd had this idea. So I'm going to pre-sketch it in just to make sure my thinking is not crazy and flawed.
All right.
Because it had occurred to me that what might be nice is if we had... Just make sure I got room for my thing. And yeah, I think I have room for everything. So sometimes I do that. I'll be like, well, do I have room? I was thinking that, you know, we got one chickadee on the one hoot.
Yeah.
But, you know, for lives, for my brave live adventurers, maybe you get a whole bunch of chickadees. Mm. Like a whole little row of chickadees. You get like the punchy chickadee and the saucy chickadee and the shady chickadee and the lovey chickadee. And so we're going to give our branch some room for all of our chickadees.
Could you do me a favor with that? You have that chalk in your hand. Mm-hmm. Right there on that apple. Could you put a little wish for Lisa in there?
Mm-hmm.
And that's one of our viewers there. Shelly was a little late and she wanted to squeeze a little wish in there for Lisa who's battling breast cancer. So we wanted to grab that in there. And so,
yes.
And I know, you know, all the light keepers who are grabbing wishes and stuff. I really appreciate that. And you know, we try to do what we can when we've got the chalk to sneak wishes
when
in.
We've got the chalk.
When we've got the chalk, we try to grab them.
When there's a chalk shortage, I don't know what y'all are gonna do. But when we got the chalk,
what size hat do you wear, Sherpa?
Is it a Sherpa size? I don't know. I think it's like a 20.
Oh, I have. Ooh, I can do that later. At the end of the show, if someone reminds me, I'll measure her head. I have.
He says that every time, and then he doesn't do it. We're gonna make a chromatic gray. We're going to take out some burnt sienna and some ultramarine blue, and I'm going to mix them almost in a one-to-one, and it's going to create a brownish gray, right? So I'm pulling out from my paint plop, and I'm mixing it in, and I'm trying to get a nice little gray and a good amount of it so I have enough for this crazy little branch that I'm going to do. I've moved my branch down a little bit so that I can easily place more chickadees. In it, I'm working the edge of my branch. I'm trying to make sure that it feels bent and weathered, as you kind of sometimes want branches to be. And the reason being on branches, you want especially apple trees to be bent and weathered, is they're not fast growers. It takes a while to get an apple tree to, you know, a nice substantial size. Mm-hmm. And in that, they have to go through all kinds of conditions and weather, and that hardens them. It's like, this is a little bit of the angry orchard apple tree.
Ah.
And now the chickadees are here, and it's making this angry orchard tree so much angrier. It's like the cuteness on my angry, rough bough just makes me mad. So we're just painting in that first little run. I'm running these lines parallel to each other, but then I'm also doing something else. I'm making them narrower, and I'm bringing them together.
Now, can I ask you a quick question about chalk here?
Yeah.
On the question was, chalk pastels, can you use chalk pastels for sketching?
Yes.
Okay.
If you use bright neon pink, though, it's going to tone all your paint. So try to use like yellow ochre or something that will blend in.
Are there any kind of pastels you shouldn't use?
I'm like oil pastels.
Oil pastels.
Don't use oil pastels on your paintings, please. Switch to oil sticks.
Oil sticks?
Yeah, I just learned this. I didn't know this. This is why I don't teach oils.
Oh.
So...
No, no. I mean like on an acrylic painting, can you use oil... pastels to mark on your acrylic?
No.
Okay.
No, because they've got mineral spirits, and then varnishes don't work with them, and they create all kind of chemistry problems. I just learned that.
Okay.
Use chalk pastels, and that pigment will go into the paint, and then you're only worried about is this blue color. Oh, okay. Would do this, or giant pink or something. But you know, neutral colors you could use. Oil pastels, no, they have mineral spirits.
Hmm.
That's what I've just learned from people who know all there is to know. And so I pass this information on to you.
So cool.
And apparently there's no varnish for it, and there's just
Now, do you paint the sides of your canvases?
I will if it's a true gallery wrap, even though this is stapled on the back and technically fits the gallery wrap description.
Uh-huh.
It's a very thin stretcher, so I don't. I only do it if the stretcher is about 2 inches thick.
Now, is that the one
But you can just do it if you feel like it.
Is that the one that I redrummed?
Yeah, that's the one you redrummed.
Yeah, it had a pretty serious, like, wrinkle and dent in it.
Yeah, from Michael's. I mean, you came back and you were like, what is going on?
I was concerned I was going to have to return it, honestly.
Yeah.
But
you didn't. What did you do?
I sprayed it with water.
Sprayed the back of it copiously with water.
Yeah, I just took Blendy's little water sprayer, which just has pure water on it, and I just... kind of just got it. I wetted it down. I mean, it wasn't drippy.
Put it by the
air conditioner, and it just dried out overnight. And boom, it was like tight as a drum. Like I would consider doing that to all of the paint, all of them before you use them now.
Well, you can over tighten a drum.
Oh yeah.
Yeah, if the drum was already really tight and then you tightened it, you can over tighten it.
Oh, that's good to know.
You know, it doesn't really come up on these economy canvases that much.
But it's good to know. You can over-tighten it.
Good to know. So I'm just trying to find a little balance on my little tree here, and I've used my number 6 bright, which has obviously been left in the water too long.
So are you going to be doing another meditation painting soon?
Probably. We like doing them. They're not actually received all that well. We believe in them.
We got to practice
some more. As a good thing
to
do, so we keep doing them.
Yeah, we're going to do more for sure. We just, you know, we gotta figure out what you guys really like in them. So if you're into meditation paintings, please leave comments. Tell us, you know, go back, you know, and tell us what you want out of the meditation paintings. We want to know.
We actually do.
We'll work on them.
I've switched to a number 2 bright. I love my number 2 bright because it gives me nice fine lines. And I am now pulling out my little twigs for leaves. And I'm going to bring a little twig out here that's going to become for the apple.
Mm-hmm.
Right, nice little twiggy for my apple, and this little line's gonna go well past where my circle for my apple's gonna be, because I want the stem to go into the center. And I'm gonna give a nice little leaf that's gonna be behind my apple. You can go ahead and draw that in, even though your apple's gonna come in later. Sometimes that'll help you achieve the layers that you're looking for. And for reasons I don't know, I've now put 3 leaves on this branch. That's what you're doing. I'm coming here, and I have these sketches of these very dried leaves, and so their lines are not very tidy, and they're very bent and worked out, and so I'm trying to make sure that I am doing that with these? Because this tree is past its, you know, whole bloom cycle.
No.
And now is doing something else.
Will their painting look like yours?
If they'd like it to, so it will look like mine. If you're just like, no, I'm not doing this. I feel inspired by you, but I'm going to go another way, and I'm going to add little R2-D2s all the way up the tree.
Well, what if you're a beginner and you're just getting started? Let's see here. I'm going to go back.
If you're a beginner and you're just getting started, man, come in for the lives, because we have a whole bunch of tips and you get a lot of information that honestly as a beginner you need, but we're trying to drop kind of simplified versions. So this guy is going to drop, and it'll be in the iCard, but it's going to drop right after this one, because this will go into processing after the live, and it just processes all day while YouTube thinks about life.
Right.
And it processes it, and so we get the other video up, and that's much more simplified and fun and still cute and everything you see in that adorable picture. And then you can do that, and then if you like, wow, that went really well, then you can come back and take what we talk about in this live and sort of amp it up. What I've been using lives for is to have us be able to ask any question you want about art, for all of us to get together and just hang out and chat and be positive, because we need that in the world. And then also to show how to take a picture up, a notch or two, and maybe go further with it. But I'm still going to explain everything I'm doing. I just explain it more and more and more.
Well, just real quick, I'm going to zoom in and over here. And while you're
wiggling this little leaf.
Now, if you do, there was a couple questions there about the stretcher bars.
Mm-hmm.
If you do over tighten, does that warp the stretcher bars?
Theoretically, it could.
Could.
Really good canvases, which were already on a tight drum that you could maybe over tighten, should be running a sturdy enough wood that it's just not a problem. But yeah. You know, I've seen some strange things in art.
So it's
maybe I'll just do some branches here. All right, so here we go. He's just a branch and a couple of leaves, and we've got this in now. Now on our branch, we're going to be working this chromatic gray, which means we didn't use any actual black and white pigment, sort of like our chromatic blacks.
Mm-hmm.
But we're using these two colors and the way they are in the color wheel to create gray. And so I'm going to add a little white to this. And I'm going to start creating my bark effect.
Mm-hmm.
And that's going to be to make these. I've got this number two bright, and I'm creating these sort of like little dashes and marks to say that this rough texture exists here. And then as I'm coming down the branch, I'm lightening my stroke so that they're very dusted, because I'll be weaving other colors and textures together to start to create this bark effect.
Hmm.
Like right here, just very lightly. I still want my deep shades. I don't want to lose that. It's gray because I'm saying this is old and dry. And I'm going to be using, instead of long strokes, I'm going to be using shorter strokes. Light as they come to the end. And I'm not taking out all that dark. You can see that I'm creating already kind of some form and shape with just these two tones.
Oh, yeah.
Of light and dark. So that's what I'm trying to do. Because I want this to be a believable little branch for all the little chickadees.
Now, Rhea was just asking some questions about what should she get as a beginner, you know, for her beginner setup. You know, like what paints, what supplies should she get?
Mm-hmm.
And I think we have a video. We have a video that we've done on that. We'll see if we can get a link to that for you. Put that in the iCard after the video.
Yeah, we should start actually putting that in. That should go like almost in every iCard. But we do. We have a video of a buying guide, and in the written part of it even talks about like, here's stuff you should get right away. Here's stuff you can collect over time.
Mm-hmm.
You don't have to worry about brands. You know, you just want to get the best stuff that your budget allows you to get. You don't want to get crazy off brands nobody ever heard of. You want to buy from a company that's going to answer a customer service question. All of the people who've been here a while will absolutely emphatically tell you that you need good customer service in a paint company.
Mm-hmm.
Because sometimes, somewhere, you're going to open up a tube of paint, woo, and something crazy is going to come out that is not like paint. And then the girl at the store is going to be like popping bubblegum going, yeah, it's supposed to be like that. It's totally normal.
Yeah.
And it ain't. And you're going to be like, what? So you want good customer service from your paint company.
And I don't know about...
Super critical.
I don't know about you ladies, but I find it extremely frustrating to go into a store and ask for help. And then for you to know like 10 times more than the person who's there to try to help you.
It and does it's make like, John crazy.
You know, it's like, I came here to ask you for help for paint, and I'm telling you that you don't know what you're talking about.
It's you know? Never a good moment.
It's like, man.
It's so frustrating, isn't it? Now, I'm going to get a little, interestingly enough, a little yellow out, the yellow oxide, and I'm going to bring it over to my gray mixture. And I'm going to add just a scotch more white to it. If you ever did the color mixing thing, the color mixing quest, you're like, I love this. Micro mixes are so fun. We've done micro mixes a few times, haven't we?
Hmm.
And I'm going to add this next value into my tree branch here. Everything is doable in painting. It's just about having the patience and determination to hang in for all the layers required to make it look awesome.
Now, I'm going to actually ask a favor here because Cheryl just asked about something that's near and dear to me.
Okay.
And that's our ongoing music.
Yeah.
So she was saying that she was saying, hey, John, could you change the music up for me? And we'll just say that she said it a little more emphatically than that. But
that's okay, sweetie.
That's okay. You don't like so. What
don't
we,
you worry about it. It's your show, man. Music needs to change. Music needs to change.
We will work on getting any music you guys want. We have to run a little bit of a baseline music, and that just helps cover up like trains and dogs and airplanes and children.
Yeah, we live really close to like an airport.
And there are cars that drive by with music that plays that set off content ID.
Content ID. That's actually happened to us where a truck going by set off our content ID. Oh, somebody's phone rang once.
Yeah, ringtones. So yeah. All that stuff is really crazy.
Content strikes, which you don't want.
So we understand that if we've got some music that you're not hip to, or, you know, I can always go find some old school jazz or, you know,
yeah, I'm sure there's some. This is our relaxing live time, so whatever y'all need.
Yeah, you just let me find, you know, just let me know what you guys like and I'll work on finding it.
We'll do it for you, for sure. I'm going to get some burnt sienna and I'm going to tone it back with a little bit of the ultramarine, but just to knock back the brightness of the paint.
Mm-hmm.
I still want it to be very distinctly brown. And I'm going to come add in this middle range here, this kind of paint right here. Those of you that did Monet's paintings with me are like, I feel like I've learned this skill. These are just little dashes. Isn't it so funny how Karate Kid we are here? Stuff you learn in other paintings becomes integral in new paintings.
It is.
We like to be like that.
It's all
We're
about
all secretly Jedis. Don't even.
It's the layers.
Huh?
They're all layers.
They're all layers.
Sherpettes have layers.
Sherpettes have layers. They're multi-layered people. But they come in all kinds of genders. Just, you know, you could be a guy, be a Sherpette, or Sherpa, or Sherple. Sherple. Sheeple. I don't know. The guys seem to be okay with it. They've been really putting up with like.
I think it's fine, Sherpette. Yeah. I like Sherpette.
Speaking of, we're working on a collab right now.
Alan was fine with Sherpette. He thought it was cool.
That's all the guys behind the YouTube videos coming out and doing a Q&A.
Mm-hmm.
We're trying to get that pulled together next week. So like Angela Anderson's husband and John and the guy that helps my mom, and we're waiting to see if Maymay from Maymay Made It can get Vince to come.
Oh, yeah, that'd be fun.
And you guys can ask questions of them.
I don't know what questions.
I feel like that would be so interesting, but maybe I'm just crazy.
Okay, so Rachel, I just saw a quick question come up here. Should we cut stray filaments off a brush?
You can. Yeah, especially if it's messing with your work.
Cool.
I am pulling some yellow oxide out and tinting it with some white. Yes, you absolutely can. Trim stray filaments off a brush, but okay. Only after you've tried to reshape the brush.
All right, there's a question I have to scroll up for.
So if you've tried to reshape it and you've done our brush reshaping video and you're like, man, I've boiled the water, I've used the shaper, of everything. I'm looking for places that I feel like the branch would catch some sunlight. Though, of course, where I put birds may alter this greatly. And I haven't put the birds in yet, so we don't know where that's going to be. So that may change up stuff a lot.
You have to slow down there. Sorry. I was reading a question here. That I was just, everyone was like, oh, could you please answer this?
Answer any questions.
Yeah, I just didn't see it until just now, so that's why I'm a little bit behind.
Good. Honey, it's hard to read those chats. It is. They just go by so fast. I have trouble on Facebook.
So the question was, what are the benefits and drawbacks to too tight of a canvas, and how would you know? So I think I opened up the Pandora's box.
So the whole reason I'm painting on a canvas, besides the fact that it's super easy to frame, is that there's a spring, right, to the canvas. There's a drum, and it kind of bounces back. And energetically, what's happening? Really? I feel a little invaded. No, measure that again, because you measured it at a weird angle. I'm pretty sure it's not 24.
Is this supposed to be right across the brow?
I don't know.
23?
I don't really have, it's not like a size ego thing, it's just, I just feel like it was a weird measure.
Maybe 22 and a half.
Okay, that makes sense. So, I don't even know what I was, I can't even remember what I was saying. I don't know what I was saying, I just got my head measured, I don't know what I was saying.
Did I mess you up?
A little.
I'm sorry.
It's okay, just... Yeah.
You got stunt hands.
I did.
Sorry, I invaded your stunt handsness. They were over here telling me, what size was their hat? There's so many questions about your hat, you just don't know.
Okay. I just don't know what I'm talking about. I have switched to my 10/0 detail brush. I'm going to just kind of create some little micro details on these branches here. This is a good way to refine these small detail areas, and you're going to want to refine them if you want them to really feel kind of dramatic and finished. So that's an important thing to do if you can. And I can, so I'm gonna.
They thought that was a good measurement tactic to actually just go and get it.
Well, I'm just, you know. We've had three children together and we caught all three, so it's probably okay.
You were talking about the canvas. That's what
I? Okay, yeah. So yeah, what it is if it's overly tight, it may not be as responsive when you paint it.
Uh-huh.
You know, if it were done theoretically enough, it could even damage, theoretically. I've never actually witnessed this damage.
Mm-hmm.
Could be an artist urban myth, but people talk about it.
Okay. So a good.
So I put those little highlights in there, and now I'm painting my little leaves.
How would you know if you had a properly drummed canvas?
So this has got a nice drum on it. It's a little loose, but it's still pretty springy.
Yeah.
You wouldn't want any ripples. Your canvas should have no ripples,
mm-hmm.
should have no sags. So the first defense against this is when you're buying these in the packs especially, check and investigate the pack. Because a lot of times the damage will show. As long as the stretchers are not cracked and this isn't out of square and you're seeing ripples, it's just that the drum has gotten loose and you can probably fix it with water. If the stretchers are out of square or they're cracked, then you're into bigger repairs. And I would say definitely on this type of canvas, it isn't even worth it.
All right. Well, I'm going to get...
I was going to get like a $700 Frederick's canvas for like $50 because it had like a cracked stretcher, John would absolutely wrestle that stretcher for me. I just mixed ultramarine and burnt sienna here.
I'm going to give an art high fives to Sheila, who has the appropriate use of rad in chat.
So again, if you have any questions, feel free to ask any of them. If you're looking for just drilled down, like where I'm just explaining each thing I'm doing, and every single move probably is going to be the single chickadee.
So now here's a question for you. Do you have one hat with many accessories or many hats with different accessories?
I have over 40 hats.
You have over 40 hats.
I think we counted them once and it was definitely over 40. Over 40 hats, for sure.
Mm-hmm.
If you guys are looking for resources for chickadees, Paint My Photo has a lot of chickadees.
Oh, yeah.
For artists. Just be sure and credit the photographer when you do your painting if you use a lot of their chickadees.
Do you have your, how's your sippy sippy doing? Everyone's like,
I'm
sippy,
out of sippy
sippy.
Sippy.
You're out of sippy
sippy. The reason
sippy?
I haven't been sipping is I have no sippy.
Do I need to re-sippy you?
I don't know. I'm getting through. I'm holding on with my blue lipstick and my leaves and this dream of a bunch of little chickadees that I feel like everyone's going to love to learn to paint. Going, oh, boy, I hope this doesn't just ruin lives forever.
Oh, I think everyone loves it.
Hope people aren't like, lives suck now.
I don't want to say that.
What's going on here?
We have, just so you know, we've had over 300 people in the room with us this entire time. We're almost at 300 likes right now.
I get another dance?
You may do another dance here pretty quick. So
you need those dances. And actually at home, if you're standing or sitting for periods of time in painting greater than 20 minutes,
mm-hmm.
It's a good idea to always have music on so that you're sort of mobile and moving and kind of bopping along. Otherwise, you can get real stiff. We can't just have my jams on here because then one...
Content ID.
Content ID. And you all might not like my music. I got some weird music. I like Macklemore. Actually, you may be like, I don't like Macklemore. I don't know how that's possible, but I mean, I'm just saying, like, sometimes people don't like good stuff. Lots of people don't like me.
Ronson.
Yeah.
We put a lot of weird stuff in rotation.
Yeah, we do.
But it's all good. I mean, like, you know, I think actually, the more I think about it,
Kill Cult.
We'll play some of that during, you know, not so much anymore, but yeah, we'll put that up on the Facebook when we do some of those mixes.
Yeah, they're starting to do content ID too.
Oh my gosh, we are at double Sherpa.
Let's give me a jam.
Oh, we're gonna have to go over.
We'll paint in an apple and highlight our leaves, and then we're gonna start putting in a row of adorable chickadees.
Yeah.
It's kind of like that owl family you guys keep asking me to paint, but I keep saying no. Blue lips. I don't know. Now they're kind of. I'm kind of liking them. I kind of feel like if I wore this dropping off honey to school, the other moms would be like, "Purple hair and blue lips. It's too much."
Is it?
It might be. This is better than when I was a teenager and like there was that one black lipstick and that one green lipstick and then you would like paint your lips blue. Don't eat paint. See things I've learned.
Uh huh.
Give me
a chance. I'm trying to find a good one. Where is your?
Now I'm just dancing to the music in my.
There we go.
Head.
Get your crazy dance on. And I will have to take this time to say thank you to all the people who are out here with us today. We've had an incredible audience of light keepers and Sherpettes to join us. It's been really, really nice. So thank you guys for coming and being with us.
Got my dance taken away.
You got what?
My music went.
Oh no, you're still music's still here?
I just turned down.
Oh, I was just talking it down so I could talk. So I've got the music in here up. She's just dancing today. You guys have got her on a dancey dance day. And if you're at home, you should take the time to go ahead and dance with us. And if you can't, get up and dance and move your fingers, wiggle your toes. Do what you can, your nose. It helps to dance. It really does. And thank you guys for coming and joining us.
I am pulling out a little ultramarine blue.
It's good to celebrate.
And visiting my cad red, and John is correct. It is good to celebrate. I'm making a kind of deep brick red.
So what are you going to do there now?
And I'm going to paint in the basic shape of my apple. Apple. So I'm going to do circle. Guess what? Not everybody has an easy time drawing circles.
I don't.
So don't feel weird about that. It's not important.
If you are feeling weird about it, what should you do?
Well, you should just trace around something that's already a circle.
Oh. Well, that seems
find
like a reasonable solution.
Find something that you feel is about apple-sized, put it on your canvas, trace around it, and you're like, boom, circle.
That's not cheating?
No, that's not cheating. There's no cheating in art. I love it. Like, artists will say that too. They'll be like, it's cheating. You've cheated. Right? Because they decided that some particular part of their art practice was super important for them.
Uh-huh.
And they've now decided to go on a rant and make it important for everybody else.
Well, that doesn't sound fun.
No, it's not fun. And I feel really bad for them. They're missing the whole point of painting. You know? The whole point of painting is about creating the artwork and being on that journey and what happens between you and your art.
Yeah.
You know, not, you know, it's like when people play Tomb Raider, like, and they only want to use the first two guns and ammo they can find.
Mm-hmm.
That's cool if that's you, but don't make that be everybody else's game strategy. For those of you that understand that analogy, you totally know what I mean. You know, people have this idea like you're supposed to play a game a certain way, you're supposed to do an activity a certain way, you're supposed to freehand everything, or you're supposed to do this. Based on what? Based on they want the whole world to have to listen to their conditions.
Mm-hmm.
Really is what that's based on. Right? And then when you look at it, it's like, well, they're maybe weak in a bunch of areas, and they got good at one thing, and then they somehow feel like there is some sort of weird platform. Just trust me, there's a whole ball of crazy there that... Yeah, you're not going to fix, and just smile politely and move away slowly. It's generally my thing. I generally take my little wine glass and I'm like, that's really interesting. Oh, I think I hear someone calling me. I got to go.
What?
You know how I am, like, at a show, somebody gets on a real rant.
Uh-huh.
And I'm like, oh.
Got to go. Bye-bye.
Got to go. I took some Just Blue, and I'm going to make a deep shadow around this apple.
Well, I can't zoom in too much more, but you can see there's a little bit of, it looks like there's a little bit of paint showing through there.
Paint showing through what?
The red.
Yeah.
Is that okay?
That's okay. That's going to happen.
Okay.
We're going to have so many layers, it's not going to matter.
All right.
Yeah. Don't get stressed. Don't get stressed. Just be mellow. Right now, you just need a shadow saying, my apple is divoted where the stem is.
Erin wants to know, she doesn't have CAD red medium. Can she use naphthol red crimson instead?
Yeah.
That'll work?
Yeah, on this painting, definitely.
Okay.
Yeah, we're not doing any color mixes that are CAD dependent. I have both, and we use CAD a lot. And so we did. Because I like the bright orange value that it has, but it's not necessary in this particular painting. You could use pearl red. You could use any red that you felt gave you a real good apple feel. And the mixes, like, with them will still deepen and do a lot of these things. So you should still be good.
Right.
So I'm going to let that dry a little bit. I got to let it dry. Let it ride. Let it ride. I'm going to paint some old dead leaves.
Hmm.
I love painting old dead leaves.
Well, Fred says...
Hi, Fred.
His English isn't very good, but he did convey that he likes what we're doing. So
thank you, Fred. I appreciate that.
We appreciate it. I wonder where Fred's at.
Where is Fred from?
He has a last name that has two consonants next to it, so I can't attempt to pronounce it. I don't know how R and J go together.
I'm going to come here and I'm going to bisect my leaf in half with that gray I just made.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm going to, on a dry brush, right, so that the paint is sort of even showing underneath. This will help convey that my leaf is very dry. Paint this gray. I might even paint a little spot right here on the outer edge of this part of the leaf. The reason I'm putting these two highlights out is to show that the leaf is wrinkled and does not have an even surface. Right? And that's what you're trying to do. I'm going to come out this edge here.
He's from France.
France. Bonjour, Fred. Ça va bien? That's like what I lived in France, and then I did spend my entire time there being very well behaved and saying hello and how is everyone and thank you and working on my French. But unfortunately, I learned French in America.
And Lynn,
and
who's...
I'm good at menu, except that one time I ordered wolf.
So I'm guessing that Lynn...
Hi, Lynn.
She's going to translate if there's a question.
Oh my gosh, Lynn, thank you.
Nice.
I've got some yellow ochre here.
Oh, and
I'm going to just dry brush this here. And I think that's so cool. when we were there, we had a wonderful guide with us, Mark Malks, and he did a lot of translation and helping us. Then we also had another very nice person who helped us out and toured us around. We were really blessed. Like, the people where we stayed really tried to make our art experience wonderful. And, I mean, I just remember my mom and I just having the best time. Cool. Falling in love with... we were actually staying in the Pic du Nord of Carcassonne.
Uh-huh.
And it was just beautiful. It was incredible. Learned a lot.
I'm guessing...
About being human.
My French is horrible, but...
Your French was really good, actually. John picked it up in like 2 seconds because he learns languages.
I think Fred's just joining us here. He normally catches us on the replays. So...
I think that's kind of awesome. I'm going to keep doing the ochre. I think I had so much fun in the art stores in Carcassonne. And
oh,
I actually, we went art shopping. We art shopped in Marseille.
Best comic book stores.
Oh my gosh, the comic book stores. French comics are so good. We're so deprived here in the United States, you don't even know.
They're so French.
The artists are so off the chain. Good.
And yeah, there's, it's just... So
I'm just grabbing some burnt sienna and working these.
And I want to say thank you
together
to all of our light keepers out here who are translating and keeping this all going live
it's
in here
amazing.
With friends. It's so awesome. This is my favorite place to be. So
just hanging out together, painting. It's so magical. I don't know if any of you ever feel this, but I always get anxious like this will end because it's so much fun to just hang out and paint together. And it makes making these videos so rewarding. Just because I get to know everybody here. And mm-hmm. I feel very connected to the people that I get to paint with. And then it helps me come up with paintings and things and be really agile to what people want to be doing. I'm working the shadow right down the center of this leaf here.
Mm-hmm.
And I am coming here. So what happens is I imagine this light source coming. And then I imagine the different wrinkles in my leaf, and I start just decoratively putting in highlights and lowlights because I imagine them. So Mr. Rogers said I could.
I'm gonna
add another little highlight to this leaf, and maybe one right here.
I'm going to plead honesty here, so I do get to audit and control the conversation a little bit. So. Let's see here. I'll say that Veronica is calling me out saying John is conveniently not voicing the goal for him to dance at 500 likes. And I will say that being that we are at 345 and that everyone is saying like, I'm a little nervous that you guys may be rolling to that number today. So
he's so gonna dance.
Do like, comment, subscribe,
he's so
and share.
Dance if you guys get him to 500, don't let it happen. Post, man, get him there now.
I don't know why.
See the dance.
I don't know why 500 was the number. And now they're negotiating it for being 400. And I would say 6 is a better number than 4.
Oh, John, I'm gonna take a little of my cad red my yellow ochre.
After you see me dance, that number is gonna be like 1,000. You guys are gonna be like, no, it's like we don't want to see that happen.
I think you guys are going to love it. I think that's something we should do when all the guys come on the show is, like, you know, dances and games. Art game got shipped.
Oh, yes, many of them did. There's a couple of them from out of seas. Like, we have one to Greece and that I have to work on. That we had it was a little more complicated. I just have to go back when I had more time for filling out forms and things like that. But we're going to get them.
Boy, it's like they just don't want us to all talk to each other and send each other packages. Yeah. What could be going on?
I'm not sure. But we all of the...
So I'm using the brushstroke directionality
mm-hmm.
of my brush to curve what I'm doing. I'm curving this apple. I'm curving this down. I've got this yellow ochre. I don't have it perfectly mixed on my brush.
It's if you could, when you hold up your... hold up the brush right there where you're painting. Nope. See, right there. Perfect. See, I'm already zoomed in on there.
Oh, okay.
So I can see it a little bit. That's
you can see how far it's... When we do the drilled in, I talk about all of this really, like, a lot.
Yeah.
These little elements. I'm going to take a little of my cad over here and my yellow. And I'm going to put some of that brighter orange. And I'm imagining the shape of my apple to determine where I'm putting this. And I'm definitely using my brush stroke to imply shape here. So not just highlights, but brush stroke. Not just highlights, but also brush stroke. And I know we've talked a lot, like we did the Chickadee last night on the live.
Mm-hmm.
Drawing that in on black paper with white charcoal.
Oh, that was so much fun. Yeah. And
I'm going to dab some of this here around the stem. Just to show that shaping. And maybe a little more blue and red. And try to pull out and define this little spot where the stem is going into the apple some to create this red shape. And then I'm going to get some just blue and just right there. See, I'm just trying to make that a little more defined in shape. Back over to the red. And then come underneath here. I'm going to make sure this is more in shadow. I'm talking about this apple a lot more here. I know. I'm sure you guys, you know, let me know when I get to the Chickadee. Do you want the rows of Chickadees or just one Chickadee? Because I don't know how tired y'all are because I've been just sort of chilling and doing this.
I think we'll start with a Chickadee and see where they go. You know, Fred and they are chatting up a French storm out here. It's awesome.
That's awesome.
I wish I had some translation. I mean, I can only pick up the major.
Rinsing major my brush out there. And I'm going to load some just CAD. And I'm going to come here and add this. This is very dry brush. And I'm just letting the canvas structure pick up the paint. And that's creating this sort of rough look for my apple. And you can see I'm using my brush stroke to create the shape.
I would have to say that it was almost confusing the response that happened here because of the delay.
Uh-huh.
So I'm sitting here, reading the chat, and all of a sudden it says rose, 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 rose. And I'm like, why is it saying rose? And they're saying they want rows of little birds.
Okay, good. Then we're hanging in for that. I'm glad you're with me. I'm mixing that gray, that chromatic gray, and I'm adding a lot of white to it. I've got to do reflection on my apple, but I don't want just white paint because that would be too much.
Mm-hmm.
So I'm going to come here and say that this has a little highlight. Now, the reason this painting is still somewhat decorative is because there is a lack of realism in my light source. But that's okay. That doesn't always have to be, you know, your guiding thing. You can do things like this and still get what you're looking for. And once that gray is there, then I can come and get a dry brush of maybe a little more white and add this slight more reflection. See? A little more reflection. But that way it's a little tinted or toned. And you get some shape going to your apple.
Mm. Okay, so here's a paint.
Chickadee time.
Debbie,
I need a water or something.
I'll get you some water. Debbie was asking a question. She's asked this a couple times, and I've missed it a couple times. Let me see if I can get this.
Definitely want to answer that.
She would like to know if I can mix Academy paint with my Pro paint, and does it hurt the painting or the painting process or
no,
the archivalness?
No, just add more pigment to your Academy paint.
Okay.
All the acrylics, if they're made as acrylic paint, should be made. Will mix if you get an unexpected result, something is the paints are not actually like acrylic in the same way. So like Academy or Soho or Lucas or Galleria or Master's Touch, all of those are still, they can mix with all the way up into Golden.
Now, would you like, I can do one of two things for you. Mm. If you need, I can put a little intermission up if you need to take a quick break. Or
no, I don't need a restroom break.
No, okay, great. Then what I'll do is I'll ask you a quick question. I'll run in.
We'll be like Twitch up in here. You know what they do on Twitch? They paint like all day and then they just, you know, go
put up
eat
a sign.
Or go to the restroom or
we have
live their lives and then they come back and they hang with their community a while.
We're going to hang with you, but we actually have like, we can't do that. We have like... Like, we have intros and outros and, like, waiting music and all sorts of fun stuff. So,
yeah.
While we're doing this, Matter of fact,
no, but if you want to, I can go make a cup of coffee. So
well, I was
going
to offer to make you a cup of coffee. And
I love you.
And
you're doing a lot. I don't.
Well, you can stand and talk. It's much
you
harder.
Guys, like,
I'll tell you what. You talk.
When you do the Q&A with him, you'll get a sense. John like does a lot. Like, there is no show.
What I'm going to do, I'm going to do this. I'm going to push the magic button. Hold on.
None.
Oh, gosh.
Seriously, none.
Can you? Can you see that?
Can I see what?
Oh, hold on. Let me see if I go.
I can see my apple, and I'm trying to decide if I painted it well or my branch well. Oh, look at my hat. Oh.
Now you can
see
it.
Be more sippy. I'm with you, Kim. I like Kim. I got to hang with Kim and meet Kim, and that was really cool. And my kids used her toothpaste. 368 likes, John. I like that you're threatening him, but I'm late here for a bit. Did you bring apples? That's all we got to know, Dwayne. Not apples. Did you bring donuts? I guess that's what we got to bring. You know? And then there's stuff. Travis, I did refresh several times, but hopefully this was the charm. Yeah, I know what you mean. Sometimes this tech is just crazy. Is he giving Sherpa chat while he goes? Yeah, he just gave me chat, and that's why I'm so distracted. Hi, Mona. Colleen said I may have missed the answer. I don't know. Did we answer Colleen's question? Share my flames doing. Share your art with the Sherpa. Yes, please, on Facebook. I love that. Oh, she's got chat. They're like so excited. Now it's a wall of high cinnamon from like everybody. And we got Zoe and Christy and Lynn and Scorpion Designs and Amber and Nipsey and Joanne and the D and Lexi and Lady and Mona and Witzel and Becky and Gail and Joanne and Gay Wazowski.
Okay,
I just made you a cast from Monsters Inc. and oh no, I can't. Oh, Zhang. I don't know how to say the first
power
name.
Has gone to her head, folks. You're
oh, it's just so fun to say, and everyone's just saying hi and like, will you do oil painting as well? Art doodle noodle. I will not be doing oil painting as well, and here's why. I can get through an oil painting, but I haven't really done oil painting in like a. We're not even gonna say how long because it will make me seem like so incredibly aged. But I really feel like if you're going to teach, like if you're going to do everything, like as a student, I will do every media. I will do stained glass. I will blow glass. I will cast bronze. I will do Lost West casting. I'll do encaustic. I'll do all that. But when I teach, I try to stick to the stuff I actually know well enough so that if you guys send me a picture and tell me, oh, hey, this, can I get the two Splenda? Yeah, I love that, but I love the two Splenda. You don't have to take all the rest of it away. So what it? Yeah. So how it is like, I want to be able to look at your painting. If you say I have a problem, I want to be able to look right at it and be like, hey, I get it, and here's the fixes, and all of that. But on oil, I'd be like calling up my oil friends to get those answers. And I just think it's wrong to teach if you don't know what you're doing. So I just won't do it. And you know, some might even argue I don't know enough about acrylic to even be here, though I really know a lot about acrylic because, you know, raised in it. But, yeah, chat going by so fast. It's so great to see Jane back. I'm so excited to see Jane back. You love encaustics so much, but I want to touch everything. I think encaustics are some of the most beautiful media out there. And as an artist, I love to do them. I might share with you an encaustic project. I just wouldn't teach encaustics, but I might show you something I did in encaustics, kind of like that. Hi, first time to join live. Hi, Linda. We normally teach painting, but we're on a coffee break, so it is really cool to have you here. And after this is over, there's a short version of this lesson, but on the lives we go long and talk to each other and read chats and goof and party and have fun and really basically don't do work. So Tina's here. First time to join live. I think donuts all the way around. You're great at acrylic. Don't sell yourself short. Yeah, I'm. You know, I really am. I feel pretty confident in what I understand about acrylic, and I make a point of never stopping educating myself about paint and acrylic. I just recognize how much information is required. I have some very good friends that are oil instructors, and the stuff that they know about their media, I know I don't know. You know what I mean? So I'd be sitting there like, this is how I learned about the oil pastels recently.
Yeah.
Because I didn't know that. I was like, you should be able to just varnish over it with something. And then I learned you cannot. So it's just that kind of just understanding what you're talking about, especially if you're helping people learn a media. I think it's just important. But I can always give you guys like spot on recommendations of amazing oil teachers that you can go study with who are incredible and sweet and loving. 374 and rising. Christina just did the palette knife wave. I have a half an hour before I turn into a pumpkin and I have to load my car for recycling and a dentist trip. Kristen K., I think you're so brave to go to the dentist. I gotta go soon, and I don't want to go. Someone is painting them some sea turtles. It's Froggy, but we know who she is. Cinnamon, is your nickname or my real name? My mom really did that to me. This is Uncle's Inker. Yeah, my mom, Ginger Cook Live. You can go by and ask her about it. She has a whole thing about how she liked the show Mission Impossible, and there was a spy named Cinnamon, and she thought it'd be really cool if I was a spy. Because what y'all don't know about my mom, Ginger Cook Live, is that in college, she actually went to her college counselor and asked them how she could become a spy, because she thought she'd be good at it.
We now call that clandestine operations.
Well, her college counselor was like, I think you should stick with art, Ginger. Though seriously, having grown up with my mom, I think they missed the boat. She would have been good.
Uh-huh.
Yeah. She's ruthless. And has an incredibly freakishly high threshold for pain.
Mm-hmm.
Her appendix ruptured on a cruise, and she still went shopping. People are like, you look a little green, Ginger. She's like, oh, I got a stomach ache. Yeah, her appendix had ruptured. That's what had happened. And then they finally figured it out. And then they took her to the hospital, and then she spent like 90 days in the hospital. So it was really scary after that. But like, she was just walking around, and honestly, what happened is like she wouldn't eat any chocolate cake, and her husband was like, "Well, we know something's wrong." So they finally took her. So it was scary. Scary to be sick on a cruise ship, but luckily she was in Canada when it happened.
Yeah.
And they really took really great care of her. And besides the lovely time when I lived in Canada, I so appreciate the Canadians for saving my mom's life.
Mm-hmm.
Really appreciative of that because I like my life with my mom. So I have an apple and it has some leaves. And now I'm going to give my main chickadee a go. So we're going to do our main chickadee in. And I do the main chickadee in with a mixture of yellow ochre and white. I've got a number 6 bright here. I'm going to kind of sketch in my little fluffy fat circle. His little belly comes right to the branch. And then the circle's a little squished. If you think of like a squishy ball and how you press down on it, how it is, his little body is a little bit squished. And you want to do that on yours. I kind of missed the chat. That was really nice. Now I just have Hawaiian print, like I'm in the SpongeBob.
Oh, really? Let me fix that.
It's okay. And I really need to see myself. In my head, I'm a size 2 still in about 20. So inside my mind. Mirrors keep messing that up, though.
I'm very happy with everything we have.
I love you. Thank you. I'm not unhappy with me either. I'm just saying that in my head. All right, so I've got his little shape in. So he is a circle, right? He's a little circle. I'll kind of put it in the white so you can see it. And then he's got a little bump, and that's his head. What will happen that can mess you guys up is if you make him too skinny. I'll do this on the back real quick. I'll just show you the number one flub that I see people might do. Right?
You should see the back of your canvas.
Yeah,
scratch paper.
I am, because I can just demo it. If you were to go like this... And like this. That happens to a lot of people. They get very vertical on their circle, and then they get vertical like this, and then they're like, he looks like a cockroach.
Uh-huh.
Is the number one thing that'll happen. So just remember to keep it flat and round with a little bump.
Gotcha.
Just a little tip. I'm just saying. So he's the first one that I'm going to get in like, oh, I almost went into my coffee. And I feel like he needs friends now. Don't y'all feel like he needs friends? I feel like he needs friends.
I do.
So I've got a little grip of chickadees. That I'm going to sketch in their basic shapes. And what it is I want them to have little personalities. So I'm going to sketch in a little friend, and I think that they're going to touch here. I'm going to do a similar sort of slightly squished circle. And he might be a little bit taller because his little branch is bumped up. right? And I'm just painting in that off-white circle right here just to let me know where he is. You can sketch this in with pencil. Later, you can even use the finished painting. If you want, I can even make another traceable of this one. And then his little head, I'm going to make kind of round and off this way because he's sort of looking at his friend going, what?
Uh-huh.
What are you saying? Right? That's what he's doing. He's kind of like, I don't get what you're saying. And we're all cold here and it's time for school. Tell stories. So I've got that little circle and that little bump. That's always fun. You know, and then I feel like you've got to have a friend that's sort of cheeky. So maybe he'll be over here and he's going to be a little bit up from his branch. Right? So let's put in a little circle. I am really just freehanding this in right now, guys. It's like an art challenge. We just didn't plan it. So that's what's happening to me. Your chickadee and your main chickadee is very detailed and explained. John, how detailed was I in the quick lesson?
That was pretty good.
Very detailed. Yeah. Every element, every brush load, every mix explained.
Oh,
but
yeah,
here,
for
we're
sure.
We're just kind of goofing together.
Yeah. Oh, no, it was very detailed in there as far as like your explanation of how everything went. We went, you know, lots of, and I think the camera has been pretty close on both of them. Oops.
Yeah. So he's going to have his little head facing more this way. So I've got a little higher bump on him because he's lifting himself up. And what's going to end up happening here, he's going to have a weird little foot up and one little funny foot down. It's going to be really hysterical. You guys are going to laugh about him.
All right.
We're going to make him a little fatter, though, because fatter is cuter. In chickadees, fatter and fluffier is cuter.
I agree.
So if you can make them flatter and fluffier, this one is still our fluffiest, so he's our focal. And we can have some more chickadees kind of coming up the mountain. Or not mountain, it's a branch. But to them, it's a mountain. We don't know how they feel about their branch. We don't know how they feel about this branch. Do we?
No.
All right. So this little guy, right, he's going to be kind of up here.
Oh.
We're going to get him sort of up here. This will be interesting. I really just want this chickadee painting, and y'all have been kidnapped into it. Is what it is. I so liked one chickadee that I just wanted to paint some more chickadees. Tell me if these lives are still working.
Oh,
definitely
everyone's
tell me
loving
in
it.
In the comments below, because I feel like I may have gone crazy.
I think everybody's having a great time right now.
Okay.
Definitely leave us comments. Cinnamon doesn't get to see the chat during the live unless I hand it over to her, which then she starts reading the chat. You guys saw that earlier, so.
Yeah, I just get to read.
She just
gets
to read. She likes talking to you guys so much. So I can't blame her. I like it, too.
So we're going to give him a little friend looking back at him going, I don't know what your deal is. That's another little circle. That's another little circle saying, oh, what? What do you mean? This is a perfectly good branch. Neighborhood's not bad. A little chickadee right here. And then, I feel like we need one more at least. How many more do we need? You guys got to help me out, man. I feel like I've just gone rogue with chickadees.
I think they want all of them.
All of the chickadees. I think we need one facing the other direction.
Mm-hmm.
So that will always be kind of a heart shape circle.
Why is that?
Because you're seeing the wings in the back and the tail.
Oh.
So I'm going to put this guy here, and he's going to be facing the other way. He just can't get in line with the other chickadees. And I'm still going to sketch it in with the yellow ochre, but he will actually be darker. And then put a little tail here that I will work out in a minute in a more defined way. And then we're going to have him looking back this way. He's like, I don't know what these guys are doing. I'm going to look back this way.
And just so you know,
he's going to be looking that way.
We have over 320, 320 people here and over 400 likes already. So thank you, guys. Thank you, thank you, thank you. I really appreciate you guys all coming out and hanging out. And it just really means a lot. So don't forget to like, comment, subscribe, share, and most of all, post up your pictures of the cute little chickadees.
Chickadees. Chickadees. So many cute chickadees.
So they want to know if it's dance time. I think at 400 likes, they're like they're
feeling like you owe them a dance at 400.
I think it was at 500 we had the agreement for me to dance, though.
Uh-huh.
Let's see what happens as we get closer to the end of this broadcast, whether or not this is something we have to debate or not.
Having this wild feeling about this one right here.
Oh, yeah? What's on? Let me go back over and look at him. Quick, change the subject. What's about this little birdie
like
over here? Which
one? One of these things is not like the others.
Oh, yeah? Why is that?
Because I can and I might.
Okay.
Make him different. I'm not sure. Or I might make them all the same. I've been playing with the ideas. Sometimes you're just in the middle of a painting going, I don't know what I'm doing, and I've decided to teach everybody how to do it too. So that'll be fun for all of us.
Well, I don't know. I can't.
I'm going to get a number two bread out.
Well, I don't know what's going on over here, but they're saying that there's definitely some dance requirements to happen here.
I think that you should, man.
I'll put
I
on the dance
show
music.
Show up and they want some dancing. Give them some dancing.
I'll put on some dance music here. I have to find non-content ID dance music.
This is blue. Oh, I'm gonna get so many comments. And don't worry, guys. I know I talk about the comments, but it's really okay. It's really really okay. It's just funny to me. Like the stuff is funny to me, but I'm all right.
Oh yeah.
Yeah, I'm all right. Oh, you can? That's not gonna get you in trouble. How is that gonna get you in trouble? It's just an MTV. Me too.
What?
You got blue on you. Be sure and dance at home. Never, never, never let life take away your right to dance, sing, or paint. Or write meaningful, deep poetry. So I'm going to get a little of my yellow ochre. And I'm going to, here at the belly, I'm going to add these little short, curved, kind of feathery little brush strokes for that group of feathers. But then I'm going to get some just white. And I'm going to come right here to the outside. And I'm going to add little dashy strokes.
So Christy said her feed dropped.
Uh-oh. Right as John danced, I feel bad, Christy.
Oh,
it's not likely to be repeated.
I'll come back out one more time.
Really? It
really, really appreciate it. And we'll find some better not that music. Something else. I'm sure I have Christmas music or something.
Do you think you have Christmas music?
I don't know why anybody would want to listen to Christmas music.
Well, it's almost getting to be... Lord, I'm already doing my Christmas designs. And you know, I've got Halloween. I've got fall. I have an ant on my canvas.
You have a flying ant.
All right, so he's fluffy. See how we've made him fluffy? By doing the yellow ochre underneath and painting the top white, it gives enough. You had this blown out.
We have over 420 likes here. So I'm just going to come say thank you.
Love John.
Okay.
Okay. Okie dokie. I'm going to give this guy a little fluffy belly. He's going to have a little fluffy belly. And then maybe I'll take a little implied tail back here.
They say no Christmas until after Thanksgiving.
No Christmas until after Thanksgiving?
Yeah.
Guys, you need time to do Christmas projects to give to your friends.
We may start you out with some a little earlier.
Yeah. just to make sure that y'all have what you need, because you'll need it.
Wait.
I'm going to take brown and maybe a little blue. I'm going to actually tint this with black. I'll put some black in it because their wings are a little bit darker.
How long have we been married?
Someone do the math, since 1997.
Oh, yeah. So there you go. That long.
That long. So we're going to fluff his little body up here, his little wing even. He's going to have a little thought of fluff to it. This part can be kind of tidy, but that part's going to be a little fluffed. Because we're starting to think about, like, what's their little shape. And this guy, I'm going to start putting in his little black markings, his little chesty.
So they say 19.
Yep, that's where we're at. And we were together for a bit before that.
Yeah. Look, I think we met in 94. Yeah, late 94, December.
Yep. So just putting in his little black fluffy markings. This stiff brush with its little crazy filaments is so my friend for this, because it just wants to make these banana little brush strokes.
So, yeah, Scorpion had a quick question here. Hmm. Let me get back over to it. It was...
Can I come down here and make the little mask?
Can you use unbleached white for cream or off-white color?
Yes, you can. Interesting story about unbleached titanium was originally invented by Sam Golden as a mistake in the chemistry lab, in the paint lab. And they had this color, this off-white color, and in a marketing moment of complete genius... they released it and it sold out, and then a bunch of people started copying the color, and what they did was they basically added raw sienna to titanium white. But Golden Paint Company went back and recreated the chemistry, and that's why it's titanium buff, is because their paint is actually chemically different, and the molecular sizes are different, and it really actually has a different opacity.
You're just throwing down some, like, I got some art knowledge.
I just thought that was interesting as hell, because it was like, it's like you and me were like, that it was a terrible mistake, but we should totally do something like this.
It's like, wow. All right.
I look weird today.
You're wearing blue lipstick.
I don't need to look like normal.
You're wearing blue lipstick.
It's beyond the blue lipstick.
You passed weird like an hour and a half ago.
I will concur with that completely. So I'm just putting the little fluffy black feathers here.
Yeah.
And I'm going to get his little friend needs to have some fluffy black feathers to help define him here. And I'm going to be doing this as I go out. So he's got the little ring around his little neck. It'll be thicker at the chest because he's facing his little friend.
There it goes. There we go. All right.
There. A little thicker there. And then here, he would normally be very sleek up here, but he's like, dude, it's cold and awesome up on this branch, but also cold. So I have that problem. So we'll give him his little cowl. And we know he's got a little beak here.
So would
fluff out his little feathers like that. See, I'm kind of scrunching in and flicking out to give him those little fluffs.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I want to fluff him.
So now, would owls be similar in shape to the chickadees?
Yeah, you know, really, especially for this, yes, you would,
bigger,
but very similar, very, very similar.
Now, what brush are you using there for the feathers?
I'm using a number 2 Simply Simmons Bright, and the way that its filaments are so firm, and then also if you add to it, just that it's small and a little bit scratchy, it is just been a lot of fun to do this with.
Mm-hmm.
For me, what's really happened here is I'm gonna add some little feather detail there. I have really enjoyed painting chickadees, and you can kind of see them coming in,
mm-hmm,
and starting to be themselves, and then it'll be a matter of putting in little eyes and beaks.
Oh yeah,
right at the end. But now I know this one is facing this one, talking to him, and then I get to put weird little funny feet in there. This guy is a little weird rebel right here.
Mm-hmm.
So I got to deal with what he's got going on, because he's doing his own odd thing. and I'm kind of into figuring out how to paint him. Because I found a reference of a chickadee being really goofy. So I was like, you know, there's always one, right? In every family, yeah. That's just being a goof.
I think that's all of us.
Huh?
I think that's what we are. I think the Sherpets are made up of all of those chickadees.
Oh, yeah. Yeah. I love when I saw Terry at Disney and I was like, she's one of us. And if she's not, she should be.
Go recruit her.
So I'm just, this one is also fluffy and up to something. So I'm just creating, I'm normally we paint these birds very sleek because they're actually quite sleek. But when they're cold, they're fluffy. And if you've got to go back and add a little ochre to kind of demo the fluff, you can. And I'm going to add this ochre up the belly to sort of show this weird thing that's going to be happening with the feet. This one's going to be cracking you all up. Always make a funny one, right?
Mm-hmm.
You're going to always, always kind of make a funny one. I am using my reference photos, and then you guys will have this after as a reference, and I'll do a trace bowl.
So here's an interesting, somewhat complicated question.
I have an interesting and probably very simple answer.
Is it safe/okay to paint with acrylic, outdoor paint, or home paint, or boat paint?
Boat paint, I have no idea. Like, I don't know anything. That's probably even a bigger manufacturer paint than acrylic artist paint. Artist paint is the smallest segment of paint manufacturer, period. House paint is... That was one of the reasons, too. Like, when you're looking at, like, is something environmentally impactful? You know, an artist got lumped in with the house paint and coating industry on the cadmium issue. We don't even use the same types of cadmium in our paint manufacturer or leads or any of it. Not that it is any of it safe to eat or safe to inhale or any of that, but it's just not the same thing. And we're mm-hmm. certainly not pouring 100,000 gallons down the drain. Latex acrylic paint, like house paint, there are a lot of artists that use it as base, especially in large scale murals. But again, it has the same sort of quality restrictions that fine art paint has. So you really have to sort of know your home paint products to know if something is what you're hoping it is.
So read the labels and talk to the manufacturer if you have questions.
And in this case, read muralist blogs and stuff like that. They're going to have the largest resource of experiential information. And they'll share with you what they liked and what they hated. Like, my girlfriend's the one who taught me I could seal those outdoor acrylic sculptures with cement sealer. I wouldn't have known that.
Oh, yeah.
You know, so you just don't know. Always talk to fellow artists. It's because we'll share. So we've got this guy's little kind of black feathers here. And then we're going to have this little group. See? See how funny that is?
Mm-hmm.
Going to be super funny when it's done. But we got to get this first bit in. Be like, hey. And he'll have his little foot there. So not a quick project. Sorry, guys. Sorry that this is a longer project than we thought. I have to remember who I thought he was.
It's another chickadee.
Who was you? I see you. There you are. Okay. I think you're you, I believe. Not sure. Or maybe you're you. I've got all these little chickadees here that I'm referencing. And I'm like, which one are you? I don't know. You get to be you now because I've just randomly decided. Yeah. So, no, what are we doing?
What are you doing?
I'm not sure. I'm just trying to figure out who I'm looking at. No, I've made a decision. Sometimes you just got to make a decision and go with it. And then paint it in. So I'm shaping him in. Always feel like you can just take it up a notch. You know, and again, if you're looking for a more entry-level lesson than this, remember we always upload those with these long, complicated lives. So that you can still experience the project. Maybe try, put your, you know, dip your toe in and then see how you want to, like, kick it up a notch.
Yeah.
You get through your one chickadee and then you think, I could probably it to all the chickadees, which is what's happened to me. See how I've been tricked by my own madness?
You just got sucked
if
into the
trick. If one chickadee is cute, more chickadees are cuter.
You could do one chickadee at a time.
You could do one chickadee at a time.
So you didn't overcommit to the chickadee?
So you didn't over... I overcommitted to the chickadee is what happened to me. I got too many chickadee. I'm fine as long as you guys are fine. If you guys are fine, I'm fine. I'm mixing a little of the burnt sienna in this, and I'm going to try to kind of... get some black going here. Trying to make sure that I've got... this is like some tail stuff. And
any suggestion on those feather techniques here with the brush?
Yeah. And again, kind of went into it deep, but I'll like right here. So I press in, and I'm really sort of flicking out, and there's a curve. If you'll notice, there's a subtle roll in my hands.
Yeah.
And that helps enforce that curve. And that's something that you really, really want. I might bring this up and level the head back and then fluff here to shape that. So I did a little more structural design right here. Maybe I'll let some fluff happen here. A lot of the chickadees I'm referencing are not fluffy, so I'm having to imagine what would happen to them if they were cold. What would they do? How would they address their cold? There really just isn't a complete row of chickadees on Paint My Photo. So you're here for the first type of... I bet this is going to get shared a million times on Pinterest. And then later someone will say, you stole my idea! They're like, no, I was here first, but that's cool. Thanks for coming by. Always a pleasure to meet people. Yeah, I get that a lot with the umbrella, and I'm like, you realize it's been sold, like, as far as I, it's reshared, like, over 250,000 times, and that's all I can even tell.
Yeah.
Like, that's the stuff I can track. I've been here since 2013, but it's cool you came. Had some feelings. Feel your feels.
Feel your feels.
Sometimes you gotta feel your feels.
Oh my gosh.
Huh.
We've been here almost 2 hours.
I know, and I'm about 30 minutes from resolving these guys.
Okay.
So, sorry.
Well, no, I was just... let me say thank you to all of our moderators who are hanging out here with us and keeping all this going, and especially Flame, who makes sure that I get a lot of these questions and captures that for me. So, thank you, guys.
You guys said you wanted a longer lesson. So I was like,
you got a longer lesson.
You got one. Did you really want it? Are you thinking now? You're like, I didn't know. Is that where we're at? Where you're like, I didn't know it was gonna be this.
Oh, I think
much
no. They're still loving it. They're loving this.
Oh, okay.
Oh yeah, they're willing to stay here all day long.
You know, it would be interesting to do that. I don't know if it would like cause me to lose like 500 subs, but it'd be interesting to do an all day paint live. I keep saying
just see
that.
How
I just
it goes.
Think it would be very interesting, and people could just come and go. And it, you know, I don't expect people to do every painting that I'm doing, because sometimes I know it's just a me painting. I'm just painting. I would like to see some rows of chickadees, though.
Oh, yeah. I would love to see lots of chickadee paintings. That's what I'm looking forward to after this.
Yeah. I'm going to put this white cheek in. I'm going to make it look like he's looking back a little bit. These guys are going to be having a little moment.
Okay.
Like they're talking. Sometimes it's nice to make them feel like they're all in the middle of some type of intense conversation. I just shared this GIF with John where this like frog and this other little frog were something. And,
toads
and
were talking.
And they did this like voiceover, and it was the funniest thing ever. And John and I were saying like, sometimes when you own pets, like you forget like how much personality they have. Sorry. But they do. They get a lot of personality.
Yeah.
Maybe even take a little of this black up here to imply this cheek looking back this way.
They would love to see an all-day paint.
Would they?
Uh-huh.
Finally wouldn't be in like a like crazy rush to get something done. I always admire like the time Locker gets to spend. She'll be like working on something for like 3 weeks. Like updating. I got this 3 inches done. But it's the epicest 3 inches you've ever seen.
Oh, Miranda says her husband is putting in a TV in her studio just for the lessons.
he's got to come by for our guy chat.
Yeah. Which I keep getting roped into unwillingly.
I think it's a good idea, though.
I'm in for whatever we're going to do. I'm just a little like, you know. Why me?
Huh? Just I'm going to switch, I think.
I built this entire button-pushing assembly so I could sit back here.
To a slightly better condition number two.
Slightly better. Is that your coffee you were dipping into?
No, I definitely missed my coffee.
Okay.
Yeah, I don't see any pigment there. Don't need paint.
Don't dip in your paint. That was a fresh brush. You just almost went in there with,
though. It is. All that is completely true. I'm going to take a little of my yellow ochre over to my burnt sienna. I'm going to tone it back with some black.
She should live in dangerously there.
I am. I'm living dangerously. It's dangerousness. This little row back here on his back will be fluffy, but will be this sort of kind of liver color. It'll be almost the color of the bristles on my Simply Simmons. And then aww.
See those chickadees?
Do you want the chickadee painting, Luna?
Yeah.
Okay. She should come sing the chickadee song. Would you like to sing the chickadee song?
Hi. I like chickens.
You like chickens?
They're cute chickadees?
Yeah, I like chickens.
Cute chickadees.
Sing, go chickadee, chickadee.
Hi, I like chickens.
You're so cute. You're such a cutie.
The cuteness is just epic.
So I just have to be so cute.
What?
Are you so cute, right?
Are you a cutie like a chickadee cutie?
Bok.
Bok, bok.
Lick, bok.
We may not have wild chickadees where we are, so she's just gone with the chicken reference.
Although we do have wild tree ducks.
We do have wild tree ducks, which Angela Anderson has witnessed.
I like chickens. Chicken food.
You like chicken food?
Yeah. It's like chicken, but not from McDonald's.
No? No McDonald's chicken?
Nope. I think I'm going to get her some almond snacks is what she's asking for here. I'll get her some and I'll be right back.
She's hopping, too. Do you see her, like, skipping out? Chicken. She's so patient. She wants almonds. She does like chicken, though. She does like chicken. We may talk a lot about food. Gotta wiggle myself out. So how are the chickadees looking? Can you kind of see the chickadee family happening? It doesn't like whip together in like 2 seconds. You know, like the other lesson is like straight up an hour just to get the branch in the one chickadee. And again, we like cover like, I'm mixing these two now. Here's the load. This is what it looks like. This is the flick. This is more like, Let's take that concept, what we learned there, and kick it up. Because I'd like y'all to be able to kick it up.
Mm-hmm.
You know, it's something you don't get to do in other venues. Like, I would get to do this with you in a workshop where we really get to kick up a project. But this is really nice. It's a real blessing to be able to.
Mm-hmm.
So I'm putting in his little cheek, which is kind of a fluffy white. I'm making sure that this is fairly fluffy. He's got his little back here. I've wiped my brush. I'm grabbing my black paint, and I'm going to try to define his little head space. I may have to. There's a boo-boo there, so it may have to go.
So Pat says she really likes the contingent of chickadees.
It, you know, you just don't get to do this a lot, and there's a lot of, I don't want to say it's pressure, but there's certainly a thinking that you've got to keep the projects reasonably lengthed,
mm-hmm.
I think. But it's fun to get into this occasion. We didn't do that today on the live, but again, that's what they're for, right?
Mm-hmm.
Unless you were like, I had a 2-minute lunch break and y'all just did the craziest thing with it. I won't tell them if you don't tell them. Last chickadee. And very then we get to come in and do feet and eyes and final details, which is always the fun. And you know that's when the painting just comes together in a New York second. You know, and I think that's always sort of fun. So I'm going to really fluff up this little fluffy chickadee. This little fluffy chickadee is the chickiest chicky chickadee. He's a happy little branch of chickadee. And he has his own song. Yes, he does. You should sing to yourself in your studio if you can. You don't have to sing along with me because that would require, I don't know, lack of music training. I'm campfire ready. I will come to your campfire and sing. You better believe I will.
Mm-hmm.
John will tell you. I'm notorious. I know all them campfire songs. I sing them. But I know not to go to like American Idol and try out, so.
You just do it on your own YouTube channel or you can torture us.
That's right. And then, but you know what? Then people can give me the dislikes.
I like your singing. And our kids do too.
It's true. We sing everything.
And there are other channels.
We sing teeth brushing. We sing anything we're doing, we are singing it.
Mm-hmm.
So I am just flicking this and pushing this in. I'm flicking this and I'm creating that little halo that I know that I've got. And then we're going to give the little black feathering that we know we have. The little black feathering we know we have.
So Kendra is asking if...
Hi, Kendra.
Can she just do one chickadee?
Yes. And Kendra, seriously, if you just want one chickadee, that lesson, this one, it would be up right now, but there was a glitch last night. This one right here, just like this, is going to be available. Takes about an hour to do.
Yeah. We actually had it all done yesterday. I just uploaded the wrong
one. The traceable's up. It's ready to go. Finish painting and we're uploading and it's just up slower than we usually have it. But yes, totally, totally, totally. See, I should have said this all in the beginning.
I think you
more
did.
Emphatically.
It was just so long ago that we forgot.
It was so long ago at the beginning of this lesson. I did not know how long it'd be.
So if you've been hanging out with us this entire time,
you're
whether
awesome.
You're live or you've done it in time traveling and this, and you consecutively hung out with us, you win a badge for being awesome.
Dude, if we could award badges, we super would.
We soon can.
Now, everything here in the detail work will be like making sure the black is truly black, and then we're going to be putting little eyes and beaks in and little feet, and the feet are going to tell a lot of our little story.
Okay.
And I feel like, and I need some confirmation, but I'm sure that these are three-toed little birdies. So I'm going to get my little detail, which is my 10 over 0. I love these rubby grips. Little thing. And I'm going to make sure that I've got my kind of jacked up number 2. I'm going to come back real quick and make sure that my black is black. My black is black. Yes, it is. Blacky black. Blacky black. Blacky black. Ugh. Just making sure my blacks are very black. And then a couple structured strokes here and a couple structured strokes there. But then back to the craziness right here that we would have. That's going to give them the personality.
They're all of our communities are going, I'm this chickadee and that chickadee is this other person. They see each other in them, which is really great.
So we have the one chickadee ready to go as a thing, don't we?
That's right.
On the store is a shirt or a mug or any of that. But
yeah.
We wanted to find out if you guys wanted the row of chickadees or the one chickadee. So we have to finish it and see.
We're going to finish it and see.
It's a chickadee off. It's a chick off?
I don't know. Could be. It's a rumble on the branch.
Whenever you get a bunch of birds on a branch like this, there's stuff afoot, right? They got stuff to say. They got business to discuss.
Yeah.
Business. Bird business. That's weird. I'm going to put out a fresh black and a fresh white because my stuff is skinning over. Ooh. And it's skinning over because it's hot and dry. Hot is not enough. If you're hot and humid, your paint can hold. But if you're dry, like if you're near an air conditioner or heater and it's drying, it will skin your paint. It will skin your paint. So I'm going to come and I'm going to load my brush. You can just see on the tip here. And I'm going to come underneath my first chickadee and make one little downward line, another little kind of downward line, and then his little friend. These are going to be defined by their highlights more than anything else. But the delicacy of the line does help your story. So, and then I'm going to come here, and he's going to be like, talking to his little friend here, see, does anyone remember those? That's what we got, see, copper, see, what was that? Did anyone ever actually really talk like that? That'd be so cool.
So the direction of the feet seem to imply a lot about how they're facing.
Yes, it does. And then we're back to Bean Man. Right? Because Bean Man told us a lot about things.
Now, you used a number two for a lot of the brush, for a lot of the...
The birds are almost entirely a number two bright. One of them is a scruffly one that I have that's been through some stuff.
Uh-huh.
And this, the other one was a little bit smoother.
And the brush you're using right now is a 10?
It's a 10 over 0 detail brush used for miniature paintings. And I'm going to just put his little foot. See his little foot? I got a little cheeky here with the foot. Look. Ooh. He's having a little moment here. Humor in your art. Right? Emotion in your art. What's the emotion you're looking most to convey? How can you do that? Right. Just, I'm trying to say, this little bird is doing this. This little bird is doing this. These little birds are doing this. And they're happy, happy little birds. Oh, my goodness.
And Kat, so Kat was just, she says she's just joining us and was asking.
Hi Kat, did you bring donuts?
So if you're just joining us late, you have to bring donuts. And luckily there's an emoji for that. So
that's all I need.
So make sure you pass the donuts around if you're just joining us late. And, but she was asking.
First get together is so going to have donuts. Our first meetup, we better have the donuts.
I think that what's going to happen is that there's going to be sold out of donuts all around wherever it's at.
I think that that's likely true. Do you see how the feet already are telling a funny little story about what these birds are doing?
It really is.
Now I'm going to take a little of my yellow oxide, and I haven't rinsed off the black from my brush.
Mm-hmm.
I'm going to use my blending gel just because my paint is so gummy. I'm going to grab a little white out. Too much white, in fact. Not a precision tool, this. And I'm going to get a little bit on the tip, and I'm going to start telling little beak stories.
All right.
Little fussy, annoyed beak stories. So she was asking something. She was new and asking something, and then I distracted us.
You did. Let me scroll back up. I'm watching your switching. What did she ask? Oh, she was asking about materials and what stuff to start with. And so I was going to say, we have a we're going to be putting in the iCard your
and
list.
It might end up in the links. Is, okay. Is Lisa still here? She'll probably throw it.
She
in.
Is.
Okay. She will probably link so it. I got to see which little. Okay, so this one we can barely see his beak because he's looking away.
Right.
So the trick of making him look far away is to make that beak look small.
Yeah.
And then this one, he's really conversing, so his beak gets to be bigger. He's talking much more to his friend. His friend is doing that. Your breath is bad. Look away. You know the one?
Uh-huh.
When your friend has really bad breath, but you don't want to tell him because it's like, you're not sure you're that good of friends? Sorry.
You're like, have an Altoids, dude.
We all have those moments, too. Okay, so I'm going to put the little beak here.
They think that one of them should have a blue beak.
I don't blame you for that thought. I'm just saying. There we go. A little beak there. Just running these little beaks, having these little beaky conversations, right?
Mm-hmm.
This little guy, he's funny, though. His beak is actually weirdly kind of like this. Because he's up to something weird. I might have to paint that back. That got away from me. If your beak gets too big, you may have to paint it back. Or you may leave it because sometimes it's like, oh, like, that's my personality. That's, like, my thing that makes me different. So I'm going to come back here and on this side create a little highlight. The top here, create a little bit of brighter. Just a little pop on this half side pop. And then, of course, there. So we've got some different personalities happening. The eyes are interesting. The eyes are interesting. So first I'm going to load my brush with a little of my burnt sienna. And I'm going to go. And John is going to struggle to follow what I'm doing. Because this is going to be crazy. This shape is more like a seed, like a watermelon seed, when the head is facing this way. I'm going to come back with bright white to define this, but the first shape I'm putting in there is like a little watermelon seed. Roll my brush to keep the paint from overloading and then reload the tip. And then you are this guy. And again, slightly more like a watermelon seed. And I'm using the brown first. It's a subtle thing. It may not show up on the camera in real life, though. It's a big, big, big deal. Up front, going to put both the little eyes right here for this guy. Kind of forward facing. Then another little watermelon seed. And then when I come back with the white, it's all going to go pop, pop, pop. This one is a different kind of eye because he's facing back. So I shortened that, foreshortened it. And that helps me. He's looking at his friend, so he gets to be a watermelon seed. And there'll be some like little adjusting that you may want to do with the feathers around these eyes. Once you figure out where you're putting them. And you may need to, like right here, I'm going to need to go back with some black for these eyes. So I'm going to let those dry for a second. Rinse out this brush because I know I'll be back with it in 2 minutes. I'm going to get my number two. And I'm going to make sure that my black feathers around my eyes are well adjusted. So I'm going to make sure that there's fluff around the eyes. See, just a little bit where I need it. This is just something that I found I had to do with these. Just to make sure I got that little feeling going. Pretty good right here. And a little adjustment there, not too bad. And then I've got to come in here and re-black this eye because I got a little crazy with the brown. Now, the last thing I've got to do, and this is so interesting, is just work a small amount of white lining and a reflection in each eye. Though you may want to, if your beaks are still having trouble popping, you know, like on some of them, you might define them a little bit if you need to. Just a little. All right, rinse it out. I'm going to go in with the white. You ready? And then this thing is going to rock, and then I get to sign it. So I just load the tip of this brush. I just stab it into the paint to load it, actually. It's sort of interesting how I do that. And the first guy I've got, he has the most interesting reflection, which is that he has a very... and then a dot. And then I just very lightly lay in the inside of that eye there. There you go. Just takes so little. Stab my paint plop. Do a similar kind of event here. I'm just barely with this white, and then a reflection right there. What do you think of that? Isn't that crazy how it creates those personalities? Just as small as I can, light as I can on the inside of this eye. And the same thing right here. And then a dot. And then a dot on my little fluffy chickadee in the center. And he feels different than this one, feels different than this one, and then their personalities are now all starting to happen. You know, and you can even, if you want, very lightly make some reflections on these feet to give them a little more personality. See that very light reflection? Makes a difference, doesn't it? John's so quiet. I don't know what's happening.
Just over here managing all the little things here. You're doing just fine.
I am. Like, man, I don't know what's going on. There's his reflection, talking to his friend. You may need to every once in a while rinse your brush off at this stage and then re-stab your paint. I'm going to say, hey, have a little reflection. Your little shiny feet. Your little shiny feet are shining in the sky. I'm having a John Denver day and I don't know why. See that? See, you can tell. Now he looks like he's looking back. That's all reflection based. Come up to this watermelon seed. There we go there. Then we're back to, just a little bit of lining here on this little guy. And now he's sort of looking at his friend. Chickadees!
Yeah.
On a branch. All the chickadees. Nowhere else on YouTube would you find this craziness. I'm using my little thin brush to sign my painting. I don't really care. I'm doing it kind of in a discreet place by this apple. We totally need to have a quest, I know, about signing and business. And
Which brush is that, the little Sherpa?
This is the 10 over 0.
Yeah.
This is a Royal & Land Nickel 10 over 0.
Cool.
I like it. They're not expensive. You can get them easily. I feel like the signature is a little big, but what am I going to do? Probably gonna knock it back a little bit.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's just a little much. It's a little bright. Eh, whatever. So, chickadees.
Chickadees.
All the chickadees. This isn't even an image on Pinterest, let me tell you. I think other artists were just like, I'm good with 3. I don't really need to paint no more chickadees. 2 or 3 chickadees. This is a lot of chickadee action going on. I think this calls in fall if you're a teacher and you've got a lot of students, or if you've got a lot of family, you've got a little chickadees in your life, or you've got a lot of little friends, or you just want to talk about family and togetherness. I think this is a really great painting to do. if you've hung in this whole time and you're a first-time painter and you're not ready to hop into this, man, please check the iCard and do the one hoot one, because you can do that one today, and then you can come back and do this one.
Oh, yeah.
It's going to be so fun to post on social media. You cannot believe. I'm sorry I kidnapped y'all for so long.
Oh, no, it's great. We love being here with you. Everybody's loved playing.
Is this the mug? Is this the mug or is the single chicken? Which is the
We're going to see. We're going to see what's going to happen.
Because I got this one.
Uh-huh.
I have a chickadee collection. I'm really actually happy with these.
They're really nice.
I like my chickadees. I like my chickadees. I like my chickadees. I like my chickadees. Do you like your chickadees? You painted chickadees.
So we're going to see everybody again when? Soon?
Thursday for Quest. Saturday is going to be a big goof. We're going to do a abstract piece. It's going to be viewer directed.
Uh-huh.
Right, and I definitely want to show you some stuff about doing some mixed media.
Okay.
Maybe some foil has been suggested. Some stuff has been suggested already.
It's going to be awesome.
You guys get to direct, and we're going to do something crazy and abstract and wonderful.
All right.
That you decide. You. It could totally mess me up. It might be a hot mess. I'm doing it with you live.
It'll be great.
Live. Stump the Sherpa. Don't stump the Sherpa. Sherpa work hard. Stump the Sherpa. I wore blue lipstick.
You did.
On a live YouTube
And we painted thing. Some chickadees.
And we painted.
And we've got over 300 people hanging out with us. We got over 463 likes right now. Thank you, guys. Thank you all for coming and hanging out with us. I can't wait to see all more paintings. We just love you guys.
At least two of you. Give me some chickadees. Somebody. Find the chickadee sword. Okay. You guys have a brilliant day, and be kind to each other and be kind to yourselves. Please be kind to yourselves, and I'm going to see you at the easel really soon.
Love you guys.